Dude, my name is Pavendra. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Ganapatibuch underscore K. I am a 23-year-old second-year student in the Northwest University in South Africa. I am currently studying BA with Tourism Management here in the Northwest University. And basically, today's video is about me telling you guys about how I basically got rejected all my life. I know, right? And how I was unable to get into university for 3 whole years, what I went through, what I did in those 3 years, and just basically telling you how I came to be here. Okay, but before we start the video, please, please, if you see me for the first time, subscribe to my YouTube channel. And number two, please do not skip the ads. And in the comment section, please comment any of your life story and any advice that you would give to anyone who's going through the same issue as we are. So let's start from the beginning. The beginning was in 2018. I was doing my matric. I was 17 years old, okay? And I did apply for universities, but unfortunately, none took me. So I matriculated. My results are good, guys. I passed with bachelor's admission into university. Like, I passed. The only thing that I would admit is that I didn't pass my mathematics, okay? So that's the only thing that... I'm not a maths person, that's it. I'm not a maths person. So 2019, my mom was like, no girl, you're not gonna stay at home, you must go to school. I don't want any child of mine staying at home. So we decided on me going to Rosebank College in Pretoria CBD. So we went there, and when I got there, I had the shock of my life, guys, because like that university was in the middle of town, basically. Like the next door neighbor of the college was APSA, the next door neighbor Cash Crusaders. So like, I'm a village girl, and when I got there, I was so scared. I've never lived in a town before, I've never lived in a city before, so I was so scared that I told my mom that, you know what, girl, I'd rather stay like a year in the school. So I decided to do a higher certificate in business management. It was a 1-year course. So for the entire year, I did it. And my plan for that year is that because my math was bad and my accounting, just for like, I'm not a calculations type of girly, okay? I prefer theory. So because my math was bad, I did apply in 2019. I did apply for universities. But because my math was bad, I noticed that there's a possibility that I wouldn't get into university. So I decided to apply, then decided that if I don't get into university, I'll go and upgrade my marks, right? So 2019 passed by. It was a very scary year for me. I wouldn't go anywhere because I was so scared of the city. I was 17, guys, turning 18, 2019, okay? So after that, I finished my 1-year course, and it was time to go back home. Unfortunately, during the year, I didn't get any acceptance letter, right? And it was nearly rejected, unsuccessful capacity, and I was just so heartbroken. So the plan was to upgrade my marks. I got 20, 20, but because I think I found excuses in my life, okay? I found a lot of excuses. So 2020 COVID hit, and I was like, oh, I can't upgrade my marks since like I have to study alone, and really maths and accounting is things that I don't understand, right? So I decided, you know what, let me just like keep on applying. Basically, I'll see what's the plan or the direction of my life, okay? So I didn't go to school 2020, and I continued applying for universities, but I would get the same answers. You're rejected, your application was unsuccessful, you're rejected due to capacity. I believe the other one in this same university that I'm in, it told me that my application is still waiting for approval. I think I will attach a screenshot here if I have time, to show you that I'm still waiting for that approval from this university that I'm in for the course that I applied for, okay? So 2020 got rejected. That means I had no plans for the year, for 2021. Go like, I had no direction. I get sharp. Then it 2021 hit, and I still applied. I still applied. I was optimistic. I applied. Oh, 2020. Let me tell you what I was interested in, because when you stay at home, like you find things to keep you busy, right? Mine was cooking and baking. So I opened a small business where I was baking for people so that I can get money, because I, well, like just an upkeep for myself. So that's what I did. Then 2020 just rolled by. Hey, 2021 rolled by. And by the grace of God, I got a job. I got a job, and I was a general assistant. Basically, I was cleaning. I got a job at Kamanya Secondary School in this program, PYEI, I think I'm calling it correctly, program LA for like we get to do general assistant or teacher assistant things. I forgot what they're called. So I got a job, and at least I had something to do. I would say that I didn't get into depression, because I'm a very optimistic person. I always remained positive. I always, like, I never got into depression, just that my days were repetitive before I got the job. I would do the same thing each and every single day without any change, guys. When I'm telling you this, please do not think I'm joking. I would do the same thing every single day. And like, I wasn't moving my body much. I wasn't really depressed, but I wasn't really happy with the way that my life was going. I was asking myself so many questions for like, okay, if this is like, if I keep getting rejected, what is the plan? But like, I was so scared of upgrading, because I was just like, what if I don't pass and I just wasted my mom's money or my dad's money? Or like, I couldn't convince myself to upgrade, because I felt like my mocks were good despite the fact that accounting and maths were very bad. Okay, so that's that. 2021 I got a job, né? And 2021, you know what DJ did? DJ accepted me provisionally. If I'm butchering that word, I'm so sorry. And I was so happy, guys. That means like that was my first yes or a maybe that I've gotten in so many years. I was so happy. And like, I remember that year when I was working, I was telling my colleagues that, oh, and I'm going to university next year. And I was so happy. I was ecstatic. But unfortunately, 2022 came and they rejected me. And I was so scared. Look, I had no hope anymore. Because Khabe, you know that thing, like your peers are moving forward and like you're still stagnant in your life. That was me, literally. I felt like I was lying to everyone and anyone about like who asked me, like, what are you doing with life? Because they knew I went to Rose Bank, I told them that I was still there, because I was ashamed to admit that I couldn't get admission to university, right? So 2022, I told everybody that I was going to university. Unfortunately, God had other plans for my life. I didn't go, but luckily they extended our contract. I hope you can hear me through this wind. Oh God. They extended our our contract for the PYE thingy, né? After they extended it, I was able to continue working up until April. August of 2022. So I continued working up until August 2022, and yes, I was still applying to universities. So after that, my contract ended. I won't lie, I felt so useless. I literally felt like the most useless person in the whole wide world. I don't know what to do. So I decided to start a hobby, because I've always loved gardening, and I've always dreamt of having like my own land where I'm just gonna grow my own food. I decided, you know what, my parents' yard is big enough for me to have a garden. I bought everything. With my last pay, I bought the seeds. I prepared. I hope this lighting is still okay, because So after that, I prepared and I started gardening, and it made me happy for the time being. And it made me forget for like, hey, girl, you're home, you don't have a job, you don't like, what's the direction? People are moving, more life thing, and you're still here. Girl, wake up. Like, it was that thing. But by God's grace, guys, by God's grace. And remember that even if we plan, even if you put in the work, when God says it's not time, it's literally not time, okay? Let me put you down a bit. It's literally not time. So luckily, I was scrolling through my phone one night, getting 4th October 2022. I was scrolling through my phone and Nelson Mandela had sent me a rejection letter, right? And I was pretty sad. I was really, really, really sad. And I decided, you know what? Because I've gotten this rejection letter, let me just check if other universities have answered me. And by the grace of God, I logged into my NWU application, and it was approved. It was approved, and I was so happy, guys. I couldn't believe. Like, I was shocked for the first few minutes. I didn't speak. I just looked at my phone, and I was with utter shock. God, I was really, really shocked. That is this me? A whole me accepted into university. I was really, really, really shocked, and I went and showed my mom. Then I called my boyfriend. I think my sister was sleeping by then. I called my boyfriend, and when you know, after calling and talking to everyone, tears rolled. Tears rolled. There's a specific spot that I sit in Kuhai, and I just speak to myself. I speak to God. I speak to Vulebadimbaka for like, here is my dreams and aspirations in life. I did this. I put in the work. So like, it's up to you guys to approve like my journey. And guys, I was so happy. I cried in that same spot that I would cry, asking God for like, when is he going to answer me? He finally did, guys. I was so happy. Now I checked if like there was something that I need to do so that I can secure my place. That same night, I think that same night, yes, I applied for NSFAS funding, and I was so happy for like, finally, like there's a yes, my first yes. And like before then, NSFAS was rejecting me. So like, it was just rejection after rejection after rejection. Got like, oh, it was so hard. And that's how basically I got accepted into this university. There's another story. They accepted me for Bachelor of Social Sciences in Developmental Studies, but now I'm doing a different course. That's a story time for another day. But all I'm here to say is, like, take time, guys. Like, I know it, maybe it's not your time. I know, like, we always want to compare for like, these people are moving forward, they're doing this and that, and here I am, I'm stagnant, nothing is moving. You're not even getting a job. Where am I? Job at retail. And I know it can get tiring and so emotional, but I'm just grateful to God that I trusted him, and I never stopped praying that he would open doors for me. And he did. He did. You know, like, he did finally answer me. And I got my acceptance letter, and I was finally happy and at ease. Because I was grateful. I couldn't wait for February so that I can register and move into race. Like, I was so ecstatic. But like, again, after that acceptance, it was like imposter syndrome. Yeah, or like, I'm 22, I'm going to go into university. There are probably kids. I'm gonna get into university with people who are younger than me. Guys, remember, university has no age. Education doesn't have age. There's no age restriction on when you should get your education. So I'm just here to tell you guys that it is possible, and if you keep on do, if you know your dream, the reason why I kept going is because I know that I hate being dependent on people. I love having what's mine. That's why I started a lot of businesses, Bobo, because I love having what's mine. So please, 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 guys, if there's something that you're going through and you're struggling with, I promise you, God is gonna answer you. Modimo arabele thapelo, guys. So please, please, please stay positive and believe that one day it will happen for you. Because there's no way your life can be stagnant all your life. Something has to change. There's no way pula ekanang every single day for the whole year. It's gonna stop and the sun is gonna come out. Just believe that in your life, like, the sun is gonna come out. There's a light at the end of the tunnel. God doesn't. So please don't stop what you're doing. Keep on pushing and God is gonna answer you. Believe that God is going to answer you. Because he would do most of a link to people, okay? Hello, gonna go. So I hope what I said motivated somebody who was losing hope, that God truly does answer and he's watching, he's listening. Your tears had really fat as a duty. So modimo ka rona ba botlhe, guys. Modimo ka rona ba botlhe. Ga a tlhopolle ngwana ope re bana ba ga ba botlhe. I think that's all, you guys. That's all I have to say on that. Please comment in the comment section what part of your life was hard that you needed to pass through so that you can find joy and peace in your answered prayers. Because I'm at peace. I'm living in my answered prayers. I'm happy and I'm grateful. And with this video, I'm trying to motivate those who have lost hope. And I pray that we all get what we're dreaming of, okay? Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate you guys. I hope I'm not dark. I hope I'm not dark, but I appreciate you guys. Please do not forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment. Love you loads and know that you matter. You matter, okay? Love you. Bye!